Hello everyone, welcome back to the Power BI tutorial. In this video, we are going to see that how can we use the Power Query and the Power Query Editor to manipulate the date and time data in Power BI. Okay, so the reason why we are using this date function, so the date data, is because using the dates we can extract the different types of information. What all we can extract? We can extract like the month, year, day, the day of the week of the month, the week of the year, the current age, etc. There are a bunch of things that we can extract from the date data. So whenever we are trying to work upon Power Query or the Power Query Editor, whenever we are trying to practice it, then it is always advisable to work with the date data because it can give you so much information. And this type of information is not possible without any with any other data source but the date data. Okay, so for this purpose we have got an Excel workbook by the name date data source. Okay, and the sheet that we have got is date source actually, and we have got at least 9 dates over here. These dates are from different years, different months, different quarters. Okay, so we will be using this data source. Why we have used this is because we have the variety of data over here. Okay, so we would be able to make out a much more information from this data source than from any other. So this is going to be our data source for this video. Let's just close the Excel file. Why we have closed this is because whenever we are trying to use the Power Query editor or whenever we are trying to import the Power Query or the data into the Power BI, any of the data, then its original source must be closed first. Okay, then you can just go to this data group and go to Excel, and this is the date_data source that we are going to open. So we can click on open, and you can just wait for a few seconds because this Power BI is going to make a connection with our Microsoft Excel workbook. And then once the connection is established, then we would be able to see each and every table or each and every sheet that is available over there. So I had 3 tables and 3 sheets there, but in this video we are only going to talk about this table 1. You can just click on this table 1 and you will be able to see its preview for yourself. Okay, so this is the table. We have got these different types of dates, and you can just check this table and click on transform data. Why we have clicked on transform data is because we want to open this table 1 into our Power Query editor. We do not want to load it directly. We want to make some changes to this data, so we can just open up it in Power Query editor. Okay, now you can see that once we have opened this data in Power Query editor, you can see its type is changed to kind of a calendar. Okay, this means that this column is containing date type of data, and it is automatically something that is taken out by the Power Query editor. It is a smart tool. It usually for itself recognizes that what is the type of data, and it could just change that particular data. Okay, so if you just take a look at the applied steps, so these are the 3 applied steps. That is changed type, which means that it recognized that it is of date data type and change its type to date. Now we have 2 options over here. Either we can transform the data or we can add the columns. Both of the options are same. Both of their functionalities are same. The options they provide to us are same, but the functionality difference is that transform is going to transform this column while add column is going to add a new column. So we can just click on add column, and what will it do? It would add new columns. Since our column is already selected, this date column, and you can see that this date from date and time group, this date option is enabled, which means we can apply any of the date operations over this data that we want. If we just expand it, we have got these many options. So the first thing we are going to do is we are going to extract the year from this data. So how can we go? We can just go to year and select year. Then after a few seconds, you can see we have got the year 2010, 2020, 1998, 2020, 2018, 2005. Okay, so these are the data that we have got. Now we can just again select this column. I want to extract the month So you can just go to month and select month. So you've got the month, that is 12, 4, 6, 3 and so on. Similarly, if you want to extract like day, so we can just go to day and day, click on day. So the individual dates would be extracted. Now you can again go to this date column and you can extract the quarter. That is which quarter of the year is this date belongs to. So you can just go to this option of quarter, and there is this option of quarter of the year, and if you can just select on it, then you can see we have got like the fourth quarter, that is 3rd December is in fourth quarter. We have some 13th April, which is in the second quarter, and so on. So these are the different quarters that we have got. Okay. Now there is one interesting thing to note. Whenever we are talking about month, we have got the integer values. And if you just see its type, it is 1, 2, 3, which means it is a number type or integer type. Okay. Now, if I again go to the date column and I want some other data, like if I want the name of the month, if we are talking about month, I want the name of the month. I don't want like 12, 4, 6. I want like December, April, June, etc. So for this purpose, I can just again go to this month, and this is this last option over here, name of month. If I just select over it, and you can see we have got the name of the month, that is December, April and so on. So we can just delete this column. Okay, this is this inserted month step. We can just cross it and delete. So this column would be deleted and we would be getting the name of the month, which is more readable than the number of the month. Okay, similarly, instead of this day column, let's just get rid of this day. Instead of getting the individual days, we can just get the day, like a Sunday, whether it was a Sunday on that day or a Monday or whatever it is. Okay. So for this purpose, you can again select this date option, go to this date, and here we have day. So name of the day, the last option, that is name of the day. If we just select on it, so we are getting Friday, Monday, Friday and so on. If you want to cross check it, so like 21st August, so we can just go to this calendar. On 21st August here was a Friday. Okay, so what we are getting on 21st August is a Friday. That is absolutely correct. Okay, so this is the accuracy of a Power BI. And there is one more important thing, that you can again go to this date and find out the age. What is this age? Means that whatever the day is mentioned, from that date to this current date, today is 3rd of October 2020. So from that day to the current day, how many days have passed, how many months have passed, or how many years have passed? So this is what we can make out from this age factor, okay, or this age option. You can just select on age, and you can see that we have got these different types of things. This is like the duration, which means in days. So if you can just go there, and actually I want years from here, so you can just select this age, go to duration. It is currently in days. If you want years, so I can just go to total years. So now I'm getting the years option. Okay, so if I want, I can just delete this age column of the days, and I can just get the years. Okay, so we cannot just delete that column because we are getting that from here only. So you can just go to date, again select age, duration, and we get total years. And you can just see it's a decimal number, so if you want, you can just select the whole number. So that is that means someone who was born in the year 2010 is having his age as 10 years, and 2020 is having age as 0 years. Why 0? Because it is some days which is not present in the whole numbers. So this is how you can just get the age of the person like this. Okay, apart from this, we have other options as well. Suppose you can just go to this date option. There are these bunch of the options that you can just get. Like if you just select on this date only, then what happens is this exact date is again shown over here. Actually, this works well when there is a combination of the date and the time data present. So you can just extract only the date data, or you can only extract the time data. So that's how it works. That's how the different types of information or different data you can just get from your date data in Power Query Editor. Also, in the next video, we will see that how the combination of the date and the time data can be used to check out the different types of information. That's all for this video, and thanks for watching.